Jay Shrek, Myths, Legends, and Lies.
And James.
James, it looks like we're in Florence, Arizona. What's that famous for?
Florence, Arizona is famous for the state penitentiary.
Don't worry, I won't let them keep you. Now, a lot of people know Florence because they have a major prison there. And you're not here because you ruined parole, did you?
No.
Okay, so you're okay. We're good. You're not going to stay. You're going to get a ride home, okay? So we're here at the museum in Florence, and we've got a meeting with Stephanie. Now, Stephanie is the executive director, and they have an area that's not like any other museum that I've seen. And I can't wait, right?
Right.
I can't wait to get in there. So let's go take a look. Stephanie.
Hello.
This is Stephanie. Stephanie is the executive director of the museum. And as I promised, she's got one of the most intriguing displays I've ever seen, right?
Yeah.
It's very unique. I don't know why, but I always thought that they use nooses over, right, on mm-hmm. executions. So Florence has a rich history in prisons, right? Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, so Yuma was the first prison in Arizona, is that correct?
Yes.
And then this was second?
Yes.
Now they brought the prisoners actually up here to help build this, right?
Yes.
Wow, that's incredible. Labor was cheap then, right?
Yeah, they built their own prison. That's where they lived.
You know, I was looking on the wall because we did a series in Ruby, Arizona, right? Mm-hmm. And one of the persons that was convicted of a murder down there of a Ruby storekeeper was actually Martinez, and I didn't realize that you have the noose of Martinez here.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Joyner. I'm the executive director of the Pinal County Historical Society. Florence has a rich history. We're the sixth oldest town in the state, founded in 1866. Today I'll give you a brief overview of our second territorial prison. In 1908, the inmates from Yuma came out here and built the prison. Yuma became overcrowded, so they scouted for a location, and Florence is right between Phoenix and Tucson. And behind me, we have the actual nooses used to hang people. Those are the actual ropes and their photograph. So Florence is the second territorial prison. Yuma became overcrowded, so they searched for a new location. Florence is in the middle of Phoenix and Tucson. So in 1908, the inmates came out here and started building the prison. Behind me, we have the actual nooses used to hang people. And you can see a photograph inside the noose. That is the actual person hung with the rope. All except for one case, they were one person per noose. There are four Chinese gentlemen behind me, and they requested to be hung by the same noose. So that's why there are four people for that one noose. We do have one woman that's been executed in the state of Arizona. Her name is Eva Dugan. She was accused of murdering her employer, and she also had four or five husbands that all mysteriously disappeared. During her execution, they botched this execution. They didn't stretch the rope or use the hanging board, and she was decapitated. This made a huge national story, of course. Arizona downplayed the story, but the rest of the country had some sort of uproar, and ultimately the prison switched over to the gas chamber. 1931 was the last execution with the noose, and 1934 was the first execution with the gas chamber. And this was a set of brothers. They were the Hernandez brothers, and they were 17 and 18 years old. They were accused of murdering a guy, and they were young, they were drunk, they didn't speak the language, yet they still executed them both side by side. One took full responsibility, one brother claimed he was innocent. And this all happened within 18 months of their first court date. So there were flaws in our criminal justice system. It's a little bit better today. We do have an appeals process and we don't execute minors. We also have the trap door over here. This was used during hangings. Since they were public, they needed to hide the body. So after it fell, their body would drop and then it would trap them.
Okay, this is the actual trap door they used when they hung all the inmates. And like I was saying earlier, what's really kind of creepy, me and James were talking about this. Me and James were talking about that they used different ropes, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I thought in my head they used one rope. I don't know why that is, but I didn't. I didn't realize that each one of these ropes are each individual person that they hung, which is absolutely incredible. And then when that era stopped and they quit hanging people, you know, then they used the gas chamber. Now, one of the reasons that they used a gas chamber after hanging, I was told that actually stemmed from an incident that happened under Belt Dam where they hung a convict, and he got trapped in the trap door, and he flung around and flayed around for, you know, I don't know how long it was till they finally put his, one of the sheriffs actually put his boot on the guy's throat to actually kill him. And after that, they said no more hanging, right? But, and then that's when they started the gas chamber. Now, what's something that's fascinating, Jane? I don't, fascinating about this is this gas chamber has two seats. And that's pretty bizarre, right?
Yeah, and as she was telling us, they designed this one specifically for a couple of brothers that they needed to.
18 and 17 year olds. And it was the last time, actually, I'm told that they actually executed a minor.
I think they at least have now obviously not done that, but this is at a period of time where, yes. Stephanie had mentioned the reason they did that is because they were afraid after the first execution having to send personnel in there to clear the one body out, so they just did it all at once.
Man, that makes sense. You know, as I'm looking here, this is pretty creepy. I'm actually going to walk around each one of these pictures because this is more like a faces of death that's pretty unbelievable. And then there's a gentleman up here I knew immediately. I told James immediately. I'm like, man, I know that guy, right? Well, I know that guy because we did. If you've looked at the Ruby video, you'll notice that is Martinez. That is one of the guys that were convicted of killing the storekeepers, right? And I'll show you that right now. So, James, I mean, did you know about the board?
I did not.
Did you know about this board? Should be right behind us, right?
The hanging board we're talking about.
I did not know that they put a board behind you. There's the door from the gas chamber right there. Mm-hmm. I asked Stephanie about, you know, if there was any creepy stuff that might have happened in here just because of that. That intrigues me. I don't know what it is, but those nooses with each one of the characters absolutely
really intense.
And you know, I didn't realize that they put a board. I wonder when they started doing that. We might have to check the history out a little bit of our, you know, because I never even heard of that.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to be doing some reading about that and find out when it was decided that was a smart way to go with the trap door situation.
So here is the original trap door that each one of those gentlemen and one lady went through right here. And this is the original door right here.
It's upside down and on display.
Okay. Man, it's, I don't know. It's just, it's a little overwhelming to me. I mean, I don't know why, for some reason, you know, you see, you always hear about the hangs and nooses, right? And I'm sure I was trying to look at the knots to see which ones were kind of different from other ones. You know, if there was any uniqueness between, you know, they use, you know, there are different styles, looks of ropes. They don't look identical. I mean, it didn't look like they had this, you know, that they came out of the same roll, for example. And they might have. I don't know that. But it's just, I look at this stuff and it's just hard to believe that, you know, they still have the same nooses. Now, some of these pictures below, they don't. They don't have the nooses. So
those are the gas chamber.
Oh, gas chamber. Okay. So the people on this side of the gas chamber and the people, they do have a noose. They have the rope for every man. That's incredible. And the one guy, the Chinese group, one guy fainted and they basically hung him
unconscious.
That's almost, I mean, I guess it really didn't matter, but man. So these are the gas chamber right here.
Interesting tidbit for the gas chamber, they built a spectator's room for those watching the execution.
You know, we've seen that before, James, about, you know, a lot of times that I don't know what it was, but even in and I don't know if I had the information readily available. I'm sure I can get it, but there was an execution in Holbrook that they actually sent out invitations. Mm-hmm. And it was done right there in the in the courtyard of the building, right? In the central part of town, and you had an invitation to come to a hanging. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if that, they thought, well, maybe that'll keep people from committing the crimes or not. But, man, I'll tell you what, really bizarre. This gal here is from Missouri, too. Nativity, Missouri. You just wonder, what's going on in these guys' heads. I mean, these were the serious. I mean, this was hanging. This was messing around. So, again, I want to thank Stephanie. And been an unbelievable journey today. We didn't expect to run into that. We did what we called a little bit of freestyle history, right? Mm-hmm. Where we just went around to try to find different places that might have interesting history, because every town's got some type of history, right?
Absolutely.
And so we just came in today and we stumbled into this, and this has been one of the most fascinating, places that we've been to. Just a last meal type of deal also is a fascinating story in itself. And, when I look at these and it says, what everybody wanted, for their last meal. Hey, Jay Shrek, Miss Legends and Lies, and
James,
we're in Florence.
We are.
What's Florence famous for?
Florence is famous for the state penitentiary.
Better make sure that, I don't even know what I'm going to say.
I checked my warrants, we're good.
Okay. Do it again.